Hi guys, Chris Rose here. Okay, so today I'm going to show you how to paint this watercolor autumn maple leaf. You are going to need watercolor paper. I used Arteza 140-pound watercolor paper. You are also going to need watercolors. I used Prang watercolors. You're going to need paper towels. You're going to need some paint brushes. I used three different ones. A very fine one for outlining, as well as some larger round brushes. And you are obviously going to need some water, and also optionally you can use some white jelly rollers for highlights later in the painting. We are going to start this piece off with a 3H pencil, so any light pencil will do to begin. Okie dokie. Well, first things first, the best way to attempt doing this tutorial is to watch ahead a little bit, and then you can rewind to try to draw along with me. Some parts of this video will be sped up a little bit, so, don't try to race with me. Take your time and do it at your own pace, and let's see if we can draw this autumn leaf together. So the first thing I'm doing is taking my 3H pencil. The lighter the pencil, the better. You're going to want to try to draw this very lightly on your watercolor paper. If you press too hard, you're going to leave indents in the paper, which is going to make it harder to paint. So the lighter, the better. So what I'm drawing here is somewhat of a pentagon type shape. It doesn't have to be perfectly symmetrical, because when you look at like a maple leaf out in nature, it's not perfectly symmetrical. So the shape I'm making is going to be, again, like sort of a pentagon with two triangles on the bottom. And I will show you a dark outline of this so you can see what it should look like. Remember to keep those pencil lines light. And you don't want it to be perfectly centered. I'm drawing it like two-thirds up the paper, so I can leave room for the stem on the bottom. And there you can see the shape that we're going for. So the next thing I'm going to do is draw in the stem and give it a nice little curve. Then I'm going to add a line from the top to the bottom where the stem meets the bottom of the leaf, as well as from those two side corners. So now you have something that sort of resembles a kite. Just remember to keep those pencil lines light moving forward. We're going to be erasing a lot of these lines later before adding the watercolors. So now I'm adding a couple dots for reference points so I can start filling in the shape of this leaf. And here is where I put those dots. Those are the blue dots. So this part kind of reminds me of drawing like spider webs. You just want to start forming the shape of this leaf. So just follow these outlines once you get to them. Feel free to pause the video if necessary to catch up. Take your time, do it at your own pace. And remember, we don't want to be perfectly symmetrical on these. If you do want to do it totally symmetrical, you can, but it is a stylistic choice. Either way, it'll end up looking pretty cool. So you can see I'm continuing to fill in these shapes to make this outline, putting a small dot in between to draw the lines from. Here's another dark outline for you to see better. And now we're connecting those top three prongs of this leaf. All of them have 5 points on each of those three prongs. And then the parts on the bottom will only have three little prongs. Points on the prongs. my words get jumbled sometimes, and it's probably gonna happen a lot more before this video is over. But I'm trying to get better. This is why I don't do tutorials that often, but I'm gonna try to do more. And if you guys end up liking this one, be sure to let me know. And let me know what you want to see next. So I'm working on those points on the bottom of this leaf here, and we're getting close to finishing the outline we're going to be painting. So now we're pretty much done sketching. The next thing we're going to do is erase all those pink lines. You want to be left with only the black lines from that previous picture that you just saw. Make sure you hold down your paper good, because you don't want to accidentally bend your paper with your eraser. And I like to also erase the outline as light as I can when I'm going over with watercolors, just to make it so there's as little pencil as possible while still being able to see your original outline. Okay, so now that you've got your outline all sketched up lightly, you're gonna take your watercolors. I'm using Prang watercolors. They are my favorite personal watercolor brand for under $12. And I'm just making sure my yellow paint is all clean, since I'm going to be starting with yellow and I want that yellow to be nice and bright. So the first thing you're gonna do is take your clean paintbrush, and you're going to make sure it's nice and wet, and you are going to trace the inside of the outline of the leaf and start to make that whole area wet with water. And I'm showing you this part in real time, just so you can see how quickly you have to work with the water before it dries. We're gonna be doing that bottom left prong. And then you wanna take your yellow and make sure it's nice and wet. You wanna get a lot of pigment on the brush, and you just wanna start going over that wet area that you just painted, and just adding more pigment, and try to get it pretty saturated. And you can see how I'm really picking up a lot of that yellow pigment. And once I put it onto the wet paper, how it just sort of naturally spreads out. And if you're more experienced with watercolors, then this is gonna be a bit easier. If you're newer to doing this, it's gonna be a bit harder. You may want to use a second brush that is smaller to get those fine tips. And then you're gonna go back and pick up some of that paint. You really want it to be darkest near the edges. Now I'm going in and adding a little bit of green while that's still a little wet, and just kind of blending it while the whole area is pretty moist still. I wanted this part of the leaf to have hints of green, and then fading to yellow, and then the top will be more orange and red. And you will see as you're painting that your paper will start to warp a bit. This is normal with watercolors. The higher grade watercolor paper you have, the less this will happen. But with any watercolor paper, if you're using a lot of water, then it will be wavy as you're working on it. This does tone down a bit once the paper is dry. And when you're working with wet on wet, you kind of just let the paint sort of do its thing until it's drying. But you're still able to pick up color as you're going as well. See, now I'm taking a finer brush to get the tips a little bit sharper, using a little bit of darker paint, but still keeping it very loosely blended into the other paint. Doesn't have to be perfect here. You can just have fun with it, but try to keep it within the lines of your outline. And you can see so far I've used the yellow, the light green, and the darker green. Doing watercolors is a lot to do with layering. So once you can't really do too much more with it when it's still wet, you need to just sit back and let that part dry, which I'm going to clean off my brushes and I'm going to do that now. If you have a blow dryer, you can speed up the process by using a blow dryer. Otherwise, it will probably take about 25 minutes or so for this to dry completely on its own. So now I'm working on that bottom right prong. I'm going to be doing more yellow and orange on this side. And starting again by wetting the paper within the outline. And then going in with some of my yellow and the lighter orange. Using that same sort of technique of wet on wet and just kind of loosely adding color, not getting too anal about it, just sort of adding color where it feels like it could use some. And remembering that we can always layer on more later once it's dry. The more fluid you are with it, the cooler sort of effects you can come up with. A lot of times in art, if you don't know what it's going to look like when it's done, it ends up looking a lot cooler than if it's all really pre-planned. Since there aren't going to be any outlines around this leaf, you do want to keep the edges pretty pigmented when you get to them. The more pigmented the edges are, the better the contrast will look against the white background. But you can always darken that after it dries. It's easier to add more paint. So for the purpose of this tutorial, I was blow drying the picture in between. I just dried it a bit here and I decided I'm going to start working on the top, since the red is the furthest color. We're going to go the other way on the spectrum. So I'm going into the top prong and getting it nice and moist, and then I'll be going in and adding the red paint, working from the tips down while the paper is still wet. And you can see now that I've sped it up a little bit, you can see how nicely the paint falls on its own without you really having to do anything. It can leave for some really cool effects, but I'm going to be going over this a bit more because I really want to get that color nice and saturated. So this middle prong and the left and right prong are going to have tips that have red in them, and then that's going to go into orange and then going into yellow. I like to leave the center of each prong more yellow so it all just kind of works together. So you can see how I'm adding different warm fall colors. And as I'm painting certain parts of this leaf, other parts of it are drying. Once other parts dry, I add more layers of other colors, just saturating here and there. We're still going to be going back over with a thin outlining brush to add red veins to this leaf. And also we'll be able to add more sharper points. You don't have to be like too perfectionist about all this. You can just kind of have fun with it, working with wet paint, just trying not to go over your original pencil outline too much, or outside of the lines, I guess. And just continuing to add more and more pigment, layering it on, getting those edges nice and dark. And you don't have to use the same colors I used. You can do any colors you would like, but this just seemed like pretty colors, pretty fall colors. It's not necessarily 100% realistic, but there's a nice flow to it. And again, this part is sped up a bit. This is 3x speed, just for the sake of this video not being like 2 hours long. and you can dabble in different colors here and there. So now I've let this dry a bit again. I'm kind of pushing off little pieces of paper that lifted up. So now I'm going back with a pretty saturated light orange and just pulling down color from the top of that top prong. Adding more water to blend it. Trying to get like a nice texture going. Adding more yellow, blending into the orange. Keeping the edges dark and the center a little bit lighter, but still really saturated. And if you're having a hard time following, you don't have to try to do it exactly like my picture. But if you are trying to do it like that, then I'm gonna slow this down to regular speed now and you can get a better idea of how this is happening. And sorry, the video is a little bit shaky. My tripod was on my drawing table when I was recording this, and every time I touch my hand to the table, for some reason, it shakes the whole thing. So, I apologize about that. And you can see how the paint just spreads itself out once you're painting on already wet paper. And once it dries, it does look a bit different than when it's wet, so you never really know what you're gonna end up with until it's dry. And you have to be so careful with those tips if you're using a larger brush. If you're pretty experienced with watercolors, then you shouldn't have too much trouble doing a fine tip with a larger brush. But if you're not confident, then it would probably be better to go with a smaller brush just so you don't mess up and make too bold of a tip and ruin all the hard work you just did. So, up to you. Use whatever you're confident with. It never hurts to try. If you make a mistake, you could always try again. And while it's still wet, you could have some fun adding some texture in there. And now I'm taking like bits of orange and just kind of patting with my brush. And you can see it's giving this kind of texture that's blending softly into the leaf. It works well with this design. And you can already see parts of the painting that have dried already are starting to look a little bit different than when they were still wet. How quickly your painting dries depends on how much water you're using and what type of paper you're using. So, it's mostly a matter of practice makes perfect. You get used to it. If you're not comfortable with it now, keep painting, keep trying, and you will eventually get a feel for it. So now you can see I'm making some of these red tips darker, making some more orange. It's not totally uniform. The only thing I'm mostly concerned with is keeping the tips sharp, but otherwise I'm just kind of freely blending whatever colors seem to look best. So you get the idea, just a lot more layering on more and more color. I'm speeding this part up a little bit just because I think you get the picture. And you can just keep going on your painting until you are happy with how the colors are looking. Always trying to keep things saturated. You can see I'm going back in with the green and just adding more and keeping that center yellow. Alright, slowing it back down to real time here. So I'm just adding a couple dots here and there on the wet paint that just kind of blend out on their own, you know, adding little more bits of texture. And then I decided I wanted to add a couple black tips on the sleeve as well, just to give it a little extra kick of contrast against that white background. So I'm taking my fine tip brush and getting a little bit of dark black pigment on there. And from the tip, adding more water and blending it down into the red without pulling too much black down. You have to be careful. You only need a little bit of black, and then you can pull the rest down using your brush with some water. And you can just be kind of free with this. I didn't do too many black tips. You don't have to do all of them. You could, but do whatever you feel looks best. I just decided to throw a couple here and there to add a little accent to this piece. And I've sped it up again, just adding more darker edges and tips to this. Once I'm finished painting this part, I'm gonna take my blow dryer to it, and you'll be able to see how the colors change slightly after drying it. And now here it is all dry. So the next thing we're gonna do is, if you haven't changed your paper towels already, now would be a good time. So I'm gonna take and I'm gonna get my dark red nice and wet, and I'm going to pick up highly saturated pigments using my fine brush, and I'm going to very slowly and carefully fill in my stem on my leaf. And I'm gonna just do it all red first, and then I'm gonna go back in with some black. But you need to take it nice and slow and just try to get it as smooth as possible. If you're going for a more abstract look, you could leave it a little looser, but I like to try to have my lines really crisp. So I just took it nice and slow. This part of the video is sped up a bit, so take your time, take it at your own pace, so it will be satisfactory for what you want. So at this point in my painting, I'm really happy with how the colors on the leaf look and how the stem looks. So I'm going to go ahead and take a blow dryer and completely dry it. And I'm going to start doing the red line veins on the leaf. So for this, you want your thinnest paintbrush that you can use, and to very lightly and gently use a saturated red to try to add these outlines. This part is probably the hardest part if you're not that used to working with paint. But the lines you're going to be doing are going to be coming from the stem to the five tips of each prong. And these are also the same lines that you erased earlier. So if you want to start with those, here's those again. They don't have to be perfectly straight like in this picture, because it's like a leaf and they're not perfectly straight in real life. But all of those pink lines from that other picture will be red lines. And then you're also going to be adding more lines coming to the red lines from the tips of those prongs. These don't have to be perfect. And you can add more or less, whatever you feel like looks best for your painting. I tried to not totally overdo it, but I feel like the most important part is just making sure you keep those lines thin. If you paint them on too thickly, it's gonna make the whole thing look kind of cartoony and off. If you're not comfortable painting thin lines, you may want to use some sort of red pen or a fine tipped red marker. But again, these are all things that you can decide at your own discretion, and work with whatever you feel most confident, and if you make a mistake, you could still make a cool piece of art out of it. So now I'm gonna speed this up a little bit, and I'm just adding all my fine lines, keeping it really saturated, hitting the page with my brush on an angle, so I'm using the edge of the brush. Now you can see I'm pulling up those center lines that were in that hard outline with the pink lines, and then kind of spider webbing off of from there, adding these veins. They don't have to be perfect. You can go and add more branches off, similar to like a tree. Or you can try to make it all more uniform and symmetrical. It's up to you. Either way, it will look good. The video is going pretty fast, but take your time with it. Be careful not to smudge your wet paint with your hand. If you're laying your hand down on the paper, make sure it's completely dry and your hand is clean so you don't smudge paint around. Technically, watercolor artists are not supposed to touch their hand to the paper. That's something they teach in school, in art school, but I've never gotten good at that. I'm still working on it myself. So just do whatever feels most comfortable for you. The next thing I'm going to do is take a little bit more black and do some black from the center of where all of the veins meet, as well as from the tip of the stem, and just kind of add black coming down from different tips just to give it one more little bit of contrast. You don't want to overdo it with the black because you got some really nice fall colors going, but I feel like just a little bit more to accent it doesn't hurt. If you're not confident using black, then don't, though, because you don't want to ruin everything after you just work so hard on it. So the last thing I'm going to do, and this is totally optional, is add a couple of highlights with my jelly roller pen. This is just a Sakura white jelly roller, and it is size 08, I believe. And I got these from Hobby Lobby in a 2-pack. I always like using gel pens to add highlights here and there on certain pieces, but sometimes you do have to go over it a couple times and let it dry in between if that pigment's really thick under it. So just be patient with that. But other than that, once you've finished your highlights and your painting's completely dry, you can go ahead and add your signature because you are all done. You've gone and made yourself a pretty piece of fall artwork that you can now frame and hang in your home or give as a gift to a friend. Well, I hope you enjoyed my tutorial. Thanks so much for stopping by and checking it out, and I hope that you are able to create some fun art today. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to let me know, and if you tried completing this tutorial, send me a picture of your completed picture on Instagram or Facebook, and I'll leave the links in the description of this video. And if you have any ideas for future tutorials you'd like to see me do, be sure to let me know in the comments. All right, thanks so much again for checking this out. Have a great day.